Welcome to VirusTotal, crowdsourced intelligence for everyone. VirusTotal is well known for its free public multi-scanner service, but in this video, you will learn how to surf our VirusTotal enterprise interface. First of all, in the top left corner of the window, you will find access to different features VirusTotal has available, including VT hunting, VT graph, intelligence, and API documentation. In the opposite corner, you can find your profile and group settings, in case you are the administrator of one. Your API key is also available here. In the center of the window, you will find the search box. Here, you can upload files or scan URLs, but also paste an IOC and get all we know about it immediately. VirusTotal is considered the Google of malware. You will find many advanced options for hunting and threat intelligence. We will do a sample search using a suspicious hash like this one. This returns a report with all we know about this file, starting with a summary with the antivirus detections, the score given by the community, and other valuable information, such as different tags associated with the file. Then, in the bottom part of the report, we find the detection tab. Under this tab, you can see the different crowdsourced Yara rules, or Sigma rules, that matched the file and its behavior. Another important aspect are the veridicts of different antivirus engines and the evolution of the detection for the file. The next tab shows basic information about the file and its metadata. File names and capabilities and indicators are just two examples of the information you can expect to find here. Almost everything under this tab is clickable and allows you to quickly pivot to get additional intelligence. The Relations tab is one of the most important tabs in VirusTotal. Here, you can connect the dots between the malware and its infrastructure and get a better understanding of its role in a malicious campaign. Interesting information here includes in-the-wild URLs, communications the malicious file did, or the parent processes that executes our suspicious file. In the Behavior tab, you can find some cool information. You can find different behavioral reports from our in-house sandboxing service or from the one of our multiple contributors. You can even pivot directly from here in case you'd like to search files behaving similarly. Under the Content tab, you will find the strings and hex values extracted from the file. Sorting them by interest is another nice feature available in this tab. For some files, such as documents and PDFs, a preview of the file is generated on the fly. The Submission tab shows how many times and when this file has been uploaded to VirusTotal, how it was submitted, and from what country. Our community is very actively commenting and alerting on files that might have relation with a specific attack and providing additional valuable information, as well as references. You can extend your intelligence on this file by simply pivoting through one of the available options to find similar files. You can get the big picture of an attack connecting the analyzed file with others found in VirusTotal's dataset. This view shows the results of your search. As we mentioned before, VirusTotal is considered the Google of malware, so you can do much more complex searches than the one we just did. If you want to learn more about it, you have a small assistant in the GUI and shortcuts to our documentation. The top right menu provides shortcuts to download files and to export results. If you select at least three files, some other options will be available, including VT graph, where you can start an investigation using the selected files. VT diff, starting a new VT diff session with the chosen files. And commonalities, finding the common characteristics among the selected files. In the left menu, you will find two interesting features, stats and clustering. The following four options are related to VT hunting. From there, you will be able to execute retro hunt jobs, configure live hunts rules to get live notifications, or start a new VT diff session. The aim of all of those features is to help you with your investigations, hunting for malware and monitoring campaigns. We will discuss them further in a different video. Last but not least, you can go to VT Graph directly from this menu as well. In the bottom of the menu, you will find a couple of shortcuts to your API key and to our documentation site. Thank you for watching us, and remember, sharing is caring.